Hello and welcome to the first Dressing Gown Diary of the 2014 Six Nations Championships. It's been a quiet and long winter, but here we are, the Six Nations is upon us. It's an exciting time. What's going to happen? Well, the stats will tell you today, every single championship after a Lions tour, France have won. Can they come back from winning the wooden spoon though last time around? Wales are also going for an unprecedented third victory. Three times in a row. It's never happened in the Six Nations. So what's going to happen? Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do in this dressing gown diary. I'm going to go through the games first off, all three of them. Then we're going to talk about the players that I think are going to make a big impact, the ones you want to watch. And then I'm going to finish off with my predictions for the final table. Well, let's start off in Cardiff. The Six Nations all kicks off at 2:30 in Cardiff. Wales against Italy. Well, Wales couldn't have asked for a better first game up, can they? It's the weakest team in the Six Nations. Wales have got one or two injury problems, but what they have got is an extremely settled side. They're pulling out big guns. Jamie Roberts back in the game. We've got obviously got George North, who's been on fire for Northampton this year. The only question, I'm not a big Reece Priestland fan, and we'll see what he can come up with. Italy are pretty balanced as well. They've got a good team in there. But still, I mean, Wales should have enough. The markets at the moment are offering Italy plus 19.5. I mean, I really think Wales will open up. They'll gel. They'll score big tries. The market there on the handicap's probably about right, though. Wales traditionally have been slow starters in the Six Nations. So this is an ideal game for them to kick off. So then we move over to Paris. France against England. What an opening game for both teams there. An absolute cracker. France have gone with the big units in midfield. Why have they done that? Well, they've had a look at the England team. The England team with two debuts there. They're short of experience. It's a new backline, basically. What can I see happening? Well, the first 10 minutes is going to be crucial. Get Bastaran into the game, running straight at the debutante in midfield for England. And, you know, you could open up gaps there and score early tries. Let's bear in mind, though, France have had an awful year last year. They were very, very poor, lost more games than they'd ever lost in a calendar season. So we'll see what happens. England are actually on the wrong side of the spread. They're plus 3.5. What do I think is going to happen, though? I still expect France to come through, but it's going to be a tight, tight game. And the last game of the weekend is in Dublin. It's Ireland against Scotland. Again, tough to call. Scotland have been poor, but they've got Hogg back, so they've got a bit more creativity in the back line. Ireland, well, can they come back from the heart-wrenching defeat against the Kiwis in the last kick of the game? I think they probably will. They have got enough, but it's a big test for Ireland. Ireland are a bit like Wales as well. If they start the Six Nations well, they'll believe they've got possibilities of Grand Slam. So all six teams enter this game, the first game, thinking that they've got a chance of winning. Italy, it's a big ask. Wales will think they've got it numbered. France and England both will think they win. And Scotland, well, you're up against it, but Ireland certainly will fancy their chances. So who do I predict are going to be the big players in this year's Six Nations? Well, I think the form that North has shown for the Saints this year has been electric. If Wales can release him, he is going to score tries. Lee Halfpenny, obviously, massive game player. I mean, it's really the big Lions players, and I expect them to come through strongly. It's a shame for England that Corbisero is injured. He was so good in the Lions tour. But for me, it's North and Hogg are the players to watch. I think attacking rugby, they will create opportunities and score tries. So what do I think is going to happen? Well, I'll go in reverse order of how I see the table. So with the wooden spoon, this time round, I see Scotland taking the wooden spoon. I see Italy next. Very, very tight for third and fourth, but fourth coming in, Ireland. Then I see England third, France second, and Wales again with the Grand Slam. I can see them winning at Twickenham. I can see them taking the Grand Slam. The way the games pan out for them, they finish with Scotland at home. I can see a Grand Slam. So for now, this is the Dressing Gown Diary. We're getting pretty excited about this weekend. I've got tickets for three of the games as well. I'm seeing France at home at the Millennium Stadium. I've got tickets for the Scotland game and a trip to Twickenham. So all in all, the next few weeks is a very exciting time for the Dressing Gown Diary. But for now, thanks very much for listening and do enjoy your weekend. We'll be back with the review show on Sunday.